When working with the Erasmus dashboard, the main thing to keep in mind is that each higher education institution can only have one institutional account held by one person, and that is usually someone in the International Office or the Erasmus Institutional Coordinator. So if you would like to get an account, please contact your International Office, as they have most probably already registered your institution in the Erasmus Plus dashboard. The institutional accounts holder may give access to as many users as needed in the institution, and we will explain this in more detail in a minute. In the sidebar on the left, you can see all the dashboard sections, and we will go through each one of them during this tutorial with more details, but first, we will look at the EWP connection. To be able to exchange data through the Erasmus Without Paper Network, or EWP, you need to tick the box to give consent of the exchange of data. This can only be done by some people in the institution. There are three boxes to be checked. The two top ones refer to the use of Inter-Institutional Agreement Manager, and the third one is for the Online Learning Agreement. These are all set to no by default, so if your higher education institution will use the Erasmus dashboard for the EWP connection, you need to switch them to yes. You may choose to only use the OLA or only use the Inter-Institutional Agreement Manager in the dashboard, and then, of course, tick the boxes accordingly. In the My University section under General Information, you can see the data of your university, for example, the name and the Erasmus code. The next two parts, the description and other general data, currently are not in use, so you can avoid filling them in. Please note that the name that appears here was extracted from the official Erasmus Charter holder list, published by the European Commission, so we cannot change it in any way before a new list is published. Accounts and access is where the institutional account holder, the main international office, or the Erasmus coordinator can design accounts and allocate access to the university staff depending on the task. In the Erasmus dashboard, each university has only one institutional account. It is possible to make different types of accounts tailored for different kinds of accesses. For example, only to view or sign and upload online learning agreements. It is also possible to create an account that can itself create and manage other accounts. The institutional account holder is not allowed to sign online learning agreements, but can create another separate account for managing OLAs, which might be necessary for smaller institutions where one single person handles everything. The institutional account holder does not show in the overview either. Organizational units is where you can make as many new organizational units as you wish, covering all the departments or faculties of your institution. Inter-institutional agreements can then be linked to these units. You can add new organizational units by using this input form and add a new one, and you can remove them by using this button. In some cases, you might want to keep the organizational units in your dashboard account, but you do not want to see it when using the Inter-Institutional Agreement Manager. Maybe, even just temporarily in this case, you can simply deactivate the unit and reactivate it at a later point. Please note that you won't be able to delete organizational units that are currently in a valid inter-institutional agreement. The My Settings page tells you all you need to know about your specific user account, in particular, your role and the permissions you have. If some permission you need is missing, contact your main institutional account holder to see if they want to change your role. Finally, please note that if you are the main institutional account holder, you will not see this tab since by default you have all possible permissions enabled. The COVID-19 tool is one of the most recent additions to the Erasmus Plus dashboard. In the section, you can indicate whether your institution is accepting exchange students and if you're also offering online classes. Moreover, you can indicate a link to a specific page from your institution's website that goes more into details about it. This information will then be displayed on the COVID tool portal at the European University Foundation website.